Unlike many of the Art by Marlene journals that are ring-bound, this newest one, which is part of the Marlene's World Collection and is named the Rainbow Journal, isn't. Instead, it features signatures that are held in place with colorful elastics, making them easy to remove, work on, and then replace. In today's 5 Minutes of Fun video, I'll show you a couple of techniques and pages from my journal. This is Marlene's Rainbow Journal, which is designated as Journal BM13. It measures about 7 by 9.5 and includes 5 elastic-bound signatures. The first one is lined paper for writing or journaling, and the others are all the same 300 GSM paper that's in the all-around paper pads. The signatures themselves are A5 sized, so they measure 5.5 by 8.25, and they're held in place. You can see the elastics on the back. They're color-coordinated to the signatures inside, and then there's this big binding elastic that holds the covers closed when you want to close it up when you're done. So it's pretty easy. And so here's the lined paper, and here's the rest, that's the 300 GSM. Taking a signature out, and I'm going to work with the green one because that's the one I've done the most work in at the moment. Taking a signature out is really easy. If I come over here, let's come over to one, you can see that these are stitched inside, and the elastic simply goes right in the middle of the signatures. So if I want to take the green one out, I'm just going to lift the elastic and slide it out. It is that easy. It's also really convenient because any messes that you make are going to be confined to that signature, and they're not going to get all over everything else. So if I look at this spread that I worked on, the paper is not hot press smooth, but there's really a minimal amount of dimpling, certainly nothing that interferes with being creative. You can see a little bit of the texture here where I didn't apply the paint so heavily. I wanted some of the background to show. I wanted this to be kind of indistinct and not completely opaque. You can see that there's just a little bit of texture here. So this design is done with the stencil that's actually named Mask BM15. I put 3 colors of Paper Artsy Fresco Finish paint through it, let them dry. I kind of blended them a little bit, and then once it was dry, I came back and I used a Pitt pen to put some line work on. Now, I did not trace through the openings of the stencil. You can. I just chose to do it freehand. And then this is the new rub-ons. I stuck that kind of down the center here. So anytime you're working with paint and a stencil, I think, and I always do, try to subscribe to the idea that less is more because it helps avoid creepage. And you can see that there's not a lot of creepage here, which I always think is a good thing. So I'm going to show you how I do this, and I have 3 different colors of Fresco Finish paint, but rather than repeat that design in that signature, I'll grab the orange one, I'll pull that out, and I will do it in here. So I'm just going to go ahead and open this up and lay it flat. So again, BM15. I have 3 of Tim's mini ink blending tools, 1 for each color. And then the 3 colors of Paper Artsy Fresco Finish paint I'm working with are Butter, Jade, and Waterfall. Now, I'm not going to do all of these. I'm only going to do this on one because you don't need to see me repeat the same thing over and over. And it's just a matter of sticking the stencil on there and placing it through. So let's move this over here, and I'll put out just a little bit of each of the colors. Obviously, when you start with a brand new foam on the tool, there's going to be a certain amount of paint that's needed to get that out of there. A certain amount of paint that's needed to actually soak into the foam and then leave you, well, let's put this back here, leave you with enough to actually get it through the openings of the stencil. All right, so now that I paint all over my fingers, let's go ahead and get these inked up so that they're ready to go. All right, and then I can do the same thing with the jade. Hopefully that's not too much paint. All right, so I tend to work kind of light to dark, and I'm going to let this span the page. So I'll start with the butter and just go ahead and put it through the stencil. And you can see, again, I'm not going for full, complete coverage. That's kind of not my goal here. I just want to get some color on here. Let's come in with... what color did I say this was? Waterfall. Good grief. I've already forgotten. Put a little bit in here, and I'm going to let this creep over a little bit more. And then the jade is a darker color, so I'm going to try to have a light hand with it. Let's come back. There. There, good enough. So I would just repeat this process all the way around. And on the other page that I did use some of these smaller elements too. You can see the color that's left over. All right, so let's move this all out of the way and then just quickly pick up this paint. Now, something that I saw Marlene do in one of her videos when she was introducing this journal as part of the whole Marlene's World collection, and I thought it was a pretty smart idea, was she used rice paper on one of the covers. So that's what I've done here with the yellow, and you can see that there's a whole lot going on the inside. I'll just show you. This is the stencil. What is this one named? BM something. Hold on one second. It's here. This one is this. And you're going to see this again. So this is the one that's BM20. I used this a couple of times because I kind of liked it. Again, this one is a different stencil. This one is, well, there we go. That's this one here. And this one is designated as BM19. Lots of different things going on here. Bright, dark colors. And then you come in and it's a little bit more subdued on this spread. And you can see, again, I reused the designs from here. So coming back to the cover, you can see that this one's a mess because I wasn't careful where I put it, but you can see that the cover has rice paper on it. Now, when Marlene did it, she used a small section to do it, but I liked the idea of taking this pretty much the whole sheet of rice paper and putting it on here up to the point where it would cover, because obviously it's not wide enough, a piece of rice paper. Oh, look, a piece of rice paper is not wide enough to cover the entire thing. So I just decided to go ahead and I wet the edge. And so when you do this, if you wet tear, you just take a wet brush and you wet the edge, and then you can start and you can gently separate those. So that's kind of what I did here. Now, the thing to know is you can see that this cover is pretty curled and it's also shiny, and I'll talk about that in a second. The reason that this is curled is because of the amount of gel medium that I used. These covers are not the same 300 GSM paper as what is on the inside, the workable pages of the signature, and so the gel medium made it curl a little bit. So my solution was to take, this is from one of our 6x12 Joggles sticky stuff adhesive sheets, and I put it on the inside, you know, I took the liner paper off, put it on the inside, and now all I have to do, if I can actually get this started someplace here, is lift the rest of the liner paper. So now this is super sticky. That's why we call it sticky stuff. And I'm just going to fold this over and let this close. And now what I've done is I've adhered that cover to the first signature. So yes, I can't work on the other side of the signature, but now I have a cover that's much sturdier and it's not going to flex as much. And I get the pretty part that is the rice paper. So this is really, it's just so much fun. Oh, actually, one more thing I wanted to show you. Back in the green. So, coming back to what I started to say, this journal is really a lot of fun. I did want to show you this because, again, here's the repeat of this design. This time, you can see I put paint on the stencil and then I placed it face down to print it. So what's left here are all of this stuff. These are elements from the Marlene die cut blocks 5 and 6 that have been out of stock forever that we just received again. And you can see that I came through and I created this spread. The background was done with oxide sprays because they're really one of my favorite to work with. And then I used, I forget what color this is, one of the dark, it might have been butternut in the fresco finish line. And then I came through and added all of this other stuff to really complete the signature. The only thing that's left to do is you can see that here I went around this with the Stabilo oil pencil, and I was supposed to show you how to do that, but my Stabilo oil pencil seems to have disappeared. So you can just, all you have to do is just trace lightly with that black Stabilo oil around the outline, and then if you grab a water brush and you can come back, and this is re-wettable so I can come back and show you that this is, well, that's too much water now, isn't it? All you have to do is just get that Stabilo oil pencil wet and it will move, and you can see that these kind of fade into the background, whereas the big one here where I've already done the work stands up a little bit more because of that black outline. So this is a really nice journal, lots of space to create in, and really nice paper to do it on.